we just took delivery the other day of 4 of the new DB Technologies DBX DM28 speakers. So here they are in the boxes, and we're going to get going and start unpacking them. Really excited about this. Okay, so what we're going to do is get these puppies out of the box, take the pliers here and pull the staples. And then we'll get our razor knife here. Got the packing on it. And as you can see, they have a piece of cardboard with corners on it holding it in place. Instructions, serial numbers, recycle warning, and our speaker, all wrapped up and inside the box. We also have the power cords, one for European 220 and then one with our 15 amp Edison on it. The beauty about these things is that when they ship this other cord with the power con on it, we get an extra cord out of it because we cut this end off and put a Hubble 15 amp Edison on it, and we've got two power cords in case we lose one. So anyway, I'm going to stop the video here and take the wrapping off this guy, and we'll shoot some further video. Okay, now as you can see, we've got the speaker out. It is pretty low profile. The front edge from kind of where the floor would be is about 3 inches. The back end of it to the top is almost 12 inches, so really low profile. Good slope to it. It's got the DBX routed into the back of the cabinet, and then the grill is held on by Phillips screws. What I'm going to do, though, because I am a open it up and let's take a look at it kind of freak for everything that I purchase, looking at the quality of the cabinets and how the build on it is and the amps and the speakers and everything used. I've done this ever since I've started buying equipment. I don't care what it is. Amplifiers, speaker management, you know, even mic cables. I open them up and take a look at the workmanship and the quality on the inside of them. So what I'm going to do is get the old Makita going here, and I won't bore you with the opening of this, so we'll stop the video and be right back. Okay, I got the last screw here that I'm taken out, and all the screws came out nice and neat, nothing as far as showing any signs of being stripped. The grill just pops off. It's got a nice foam on the inside of it that will help keep beer or whatever out of this thing. And now you can see the inside of the DM28. We've got our horn and then our two 8-inch Neo drivers inside there. And then we've got, looks like, 3 ports on it. And what I'm going to do is end up with a screw gun again and pull out one of these speakers, and I'm going to pull out the horn, and we'll get a little bit further into it. I'm going to zoom in here and be right back. Okay, we've got the last screw coming out of this 8-inch Neo, and as you can see, these are threaded. I'm not sure the millimeter of them, but makes it nice for when you have to pull drivers in and out, that you're not going to strip out the holes where the screws mount the speaker. So we've got the speaker here, and it is on little push-ons, which I'm going to attempt to wiggle off here. They're on pretty stinking good. There we go. So we're out. Neo 8-inch, 8-ohm driver. Build quality seems pretty good. It looks like it's got a cast basket on it. And suspension on the cone is pretty tight. Of course, it's brand new. But really pretty light. It's gasketed around the backside here as it fits into the cavity. And what we're going to do now is end up pulling the horn out so that we can get a better picture of the inside of the cavity as we take a look at the DigiPro amplifier. So I'm going to go ahead and again stop the video here. And pulling the drivers out, noticing the pigtail on them, they are parallel together, so they're presenting a 4-ohm load to the DigiPro amplifier inside the unit. So just thought that was worth mentioning. And now I've got the last screw out of the horn assembly here, and it is gasketed around. It looks like a little sticky gasket material. And the horn is on part of the umbilical, so to speak, that pulls this thing out. So we've got a plus and a minus on here. And what I'm going to do is go ahead and pull this out, and I'm going to well, here we've got it tagged up with a SO9 sub underneath of it, as you can see here, so we can really we typically will put these subs up on stage just to kind of round out the mix, and you use one for, you know, a drum monitor as well. We've got the DM28 set up with an XLR input, and then the PowerCon input on the side, set it to 0 dB, and we've got it set in full range mode. And we've got audio coming out of it. The dispersion pattern on the horn, which is sitting up in here, gives you a good throw down the front and kind of evens off the top, as you can see from the earlier images of that horn. But the just the tonal quality of the thing is just phenomenal. And, you know, off to the side, you can still hear coverage of the horn. I'm off probably, you know, a good 45 degrees right now. I will put it on the floor and we'll play with it kind of in a monitor mode as well. So with the coverage of these, off at, you know, the 30 to 45 degree angles on the sides, and good forward coverage on them. These are excellent monitors, highly recommended, very low profile, and vocal clarity out of these and instrument clarity is fantastic. Coverage across the stage with the four of these that we're going to be putting up, any musician would just be absolutely happy with the vocal and instrument coverage of these guys. They do make a 12 and a 15, the DM12 and the DM15, that will that have a 12 inch and a 15 inch driver in them that will produce more more low end. But these, you know, with the DigiPro amps in them and the power that is going into these 2/8 and also into the horn, 750 watts total, these things sound absolutely fantastic and get so stinking loud. So we like them, love them, can't wait to do our first gig with them. We're going to be doing a concert in the park series that we got signed up to do here, one of our local communities, and going to be 5 Saturday nights of concerts in the park, so I'm looking forward to that. And if you want a quote on any DB Technologies equipment, we are dealers for DB Technologies, so you can look us up on the web at www.trinityprosound.com or give us a call at area code 209-832-8023, and we thank you much for stopping by our channel here on YouTube.